Hey, what's up, everybody? Gonna do a classic rock reaction, man. This is an album reaction coming your way, man. And it's featuring the music of Elton John. And it's brought to us by another John, John Hampton. And this is the album, Don't Shoot Me, I'm Only the Piano Player. John Hampton says, hey, man, Elton John doesn't get the recognition for his volume of work over the years. And he's so prolific that one usually only hears his hits. But with me, his whole albums are hits. I can't hear Daniel without hearing Teacher, I Need You right after it. Van Halen was not the first rocker to appreciate the Teachers. Anyways, I found a good playlist with the original songs and without the extra songs from the remastered disc. I think you'll love it. It has some great stories, some dancing feet kind of music, and a couple of ballads. Hope you're going to enjoy it. Peace. Right on, John. Thanks, man. I appreciate that. So, let's hit it up. Sir Elton John. The great Elton John. It's been more than a minute since I've done an Elton John reaction, so this is going to be cool. Of course, I've done a couple of songs from this album, but not the whole thing. So, let's go all the way through, man. Don't Shoot Me, I'm Only the Piano Player. Let's get it. Cheers to you. Is this your favorite Elton John song? Is it possible to actually name a favorite? Let me know.
See Daniel waving goodbye.
use this one song to have a successful career. Of course, he's got many. This teacher must be fine as hell. I didn't have any fine teachers, man. Good tune. I'm sure quite a few of you can relate to this story about a fine-ass teacher. Not me.
Yeah.
what I call the breasts. The presence of breasts and music just seems to make the song bigger. It just amplifies it more, doesn't it? Makes me visualize like an orchestra size ensemble.
Greyhound is swift, and the red to your skin.
important life for song.
Chasing some poor criminal, and I guess they're out to kill. Oh, there must be shackles. stumbling through the devil door with the hound packed in for cry. Have mercy on the criminal who has run upon the law. Are you blind to the winds of change? Don't you hear him anymore? Pray, Lord, you gotta help me. Digging in the face of a rifle butt while the wardens hold you down. And I've never seen a friend in years. Oh, it turns your heart to stone. Gonna be your home.
That to my favorites list, my Elton John's favorites list. Fun hopping song. Little upbeat.
I heard from a friend you've been messing around with a cute little thing I've been dating uptown. Well, I don't know if I like that idea much. Well, you better stay clear. I might start acting rough. You out of town guys sure think you're real keen. Think all of us boys here are homespun and green. But that's wrong, my friend. So get this through your head. We're tough and we're Texan with necks good and red. So it's ki-yi-yi-yi-yi, too long hands is sure gonna die. Our American home is clean till you can. And kids still respect the president's name. And the eagle
sit there and drink all our beer. Oh, it's made for us workers who sweat, spit and swear. The minds of our daughters are poisoned by you, with your communistic politics and them Negro blues. Well, I'm gonna quit talking and take action now. Mess up our lives, spending the summer time naturally high. And it's ki-yi-yi-yi-yi, you long haired, you're gonna die. Our American home is clean till you came, and kids still respected the president's name. And the
interesting song. I'm thinking of a couple of individuals that song really seems to fit. I'm sure you guys can think of a few. Some of you old cats, I bet you've been dancing to this for a long time.
Well,
I wonder if that's his biggest hit. Biggest, most successful. Great album. Coming by way of a really excellent, fantastic artist, man. One of the best ever in Elton John. Music is so sweet, so beautiful. You know, the sound that this guy creates, his voice signature, his delivery, of course, his musicianship and the musicianship around him. It's just locked in so tight, man. I'm telling you, Elton John definitely has it going on. Is there a bad song from Elton John? I'm going to assume that yes, there is. I can't think of one, though. Yeah, man. That's how great this guy is. Let's give the man some love here. Excellent album. Let's read just a little snippet on the man himself. He needs no introduction, but I'm going to give him one anyway. And then a little bit on the album, man. Sir Elton John. Sir Elton Hercules John, CBE, is an English singer, pianist, and composer with a career spanning six decades, collaborating with lyricist Bernie Taupin since 1967 on more than 30 albums. John has sold over 300 million records, making him one of the best-selling music artists of all time. Unbelievable. Who has sold more records than Elton John? Who's the best-selling artist of all time? Is it the Beatles? Let me know. John has received 5 Grammy Awards, 5 Brit Awards, including for outstanding contribution to music, 2 Academy Awards, 2 Golden Globes, a Tony Award, a Disney Legends Award, and a Kennedy Center Honor. In 2004, Rolling Stone ranked him 49th on its list of the 100 influential musicians of the rock and roll era. He was inducted into the Songwriters Hall of Fame in 92 and the Rock and Roll Hall of Fame in 94, and is a fellow of the British Academy of Songwriters, Composers, and Authors. He was knighted by Queen Elizabeth II for services to music and charitable services in 98. In 2019, French President Emmanuel Macron presented John with France's highest civilian award, the Légion d'honneur, and called him a melodic genius and praised his work on behalf of the LGBT community. John has more than 50 top 40 hits in the UK singles chart and US Billboard Hot 100, including 9 number ones in the UK and 9 in the US, as well as 7 consecutive number one albums in the US. Damn, man. This shit just keeps rolling. Let's stop there. It's amazing all of the shit that he's accomplished and all of the awards and accolades, man. You get the idea. Damn. Don't Shoot Me, I'm Only the Piano Player is the 6th studio album by English singer-songwriter Elton John. Released in January of 73 by DJM Records, it was John's 6th normal studio album release, first of his 2 studio albums released in 73. Second one was Goodbye Yellow Brick Road, released 9 months later, and was his 2nd straight number one album in the US and first number one album in the UK. The lead single, Crocodile Rock, yielded John his first number one single in both the US and Canada. Daniel was also a major hit from the album, giving him his 2nd Canadian number one single on the RPM Top Singles chart and number 2 on the US Billboard Hot 100, and reaching number 4 in the UK, one place higher than achieved by Crocodile Rock. Background. The team returned to France to record at the Chateau de Horville, also known at the time as Strawberry Studios, which was how the studio was credited in the album sleeve. Honky Chateau, the previous Elton John album, had been recorded there. The album featured horns arranged by producer Gus Dudgeon on Elderberry Wine, the B-side to Crocodile Rock, Midnight Creeper, and I'm Gonna Be a Teenage Idol, the latter of which was inspired by John's friend T-Rex frontman Mark Bolan. I remember Elton John was in that video, Bang a Gong, Get It On video. He was playing piano. So I think he was just a guest, being a good friend of the band, but he wasn't actually officially a member of the band. That tripped me out when I saw him in that video. The horn players were the same ones who were used on Honky Chateau. Paul Buckmaster returned to add strings on Blues for Me and My Baby and Have Mercy on the Criminal. Yeah, man, That was the standout song for me on that album. It was kind of like, even though I'd heard it before, it was the first listen really, really getting it, taking it in. And it's the standout song for me on this album, man. You know, of course, his signature hits are always going to be up there, but it's like a new discovery. You know how you feel about a song that, oh my God, how did I miss this one? I feel that way about Have Mercy on the Criminal. Great song. During his Australian concerts with the Melbourne Symphony Orchestra. Why was that so hard? In 86, John lauded Buckmaster's work on songs such as Have Mercy on the Criminal, calling the string arrangements revolutionary. The title of the album came from friend and actor-comedian Groucho Marx. Elton was playing the piano at a party at Groucho's home. Groucho, who referred to him as John Elton, held out his middle and index finger in the style of a pistol. Elton then raised his hands and said, "Don't shoot me, I'm only the piano player," at Marx's gun imitation. The album was a huge hit on both sides of the Atlantic, topping the UK and US album charts. It's one of the only three albums to feature just a core band of John on piano and keyboards, Davey Johnstone on guitars, Dee Murray bass, and Nigel Olsen on drums, without percussionist Ray Cooper. The other two are Honky Chateau in 72, bar a performance by Cooper on congas on the song Amy, and Breaking Hearts in 84. An outtake of note was a re-recording of Skyline Pigeon, which became the B-side to the single of Daniel. Critics at the time called some of the performances, especially Crocodile Rock, derivative, which John Feeling freely acknowledged years later. In his song The Musical Journey of Elton John by author Elizabeth Rosenthal, John said Crocodile Rock was written as an overt homage to 50s records, and his vocal intentionally mimicked singer Bobby V. High Flying Bird was intended to sound like a Van Morrison record, and Midnight Creeper was a tip of the hat to the Rolling Stones. Midnight Rambler, Midnight Creeper, got it. John toured Australia during 71 and was so inspired by Daddy Cool's hit single Eagle Rock that with Taupin he wrote Crocodile Rock. The cover of this album has a photo of lyricist Taupin wearing a Daddy Who promotional badge. Don't Shoot Me was also, according to John, the first album during which he felt comfortable experimenting with his vocal performances and style. Packaging. The album's title comes from something Elton said during an event spent with Groucho Marx. Okay, it's repeating the same story from the previous section. Yeah, so we got that story already. On the wall is a movie poster advertising the Marx Brothers' 1940 film Go West as a tribute to Groucho Marx. The album's cover photograph, which shows a young couple outside a movie theater whose marquee reads, "Don't Shoot Me, I'm Only the Piano Player," is starring Elton John. Okay, got it. The title is also a play on the 1960 Franco Truffaut film Shoot the Piano Player and the original Oscar Wilde quote, "Don't shoot the piano player, he's doing his best," which Wilde said he saw in a saloon on a visit to the U.S. Wow, some really, really interesting history about this album, man. He gathered all of those resources and all of that bits and tidbits of information, and also his experiences influenced by Groucho Marx, and that's how this, I guess, the concept of the album came into being. It's amazing, you know, so how some of the music comes to us, how the inspiration comes to these artists, pulling it from all different areas of their experience over time, and then they produce something like this. I find that stuff fabulous, just to see the formation of how a song, or even more so an album, comes along. Alright, man. So, y'all, that concludes our look at the great Elton John and this fantastic album, man. The guy's got some great, great talent, some excellent skills, and a fantastic lyricist in Bernie Taupin. He's really got it all going on, man. I wonder what Elton is up to these days. He's really up there. I know he's older. I don't know how he's doing health-wise or whatever it is, but I got to see what he's up to right now as we speak, if he's still performing, if he's only doing it occasionally, what he's up to right now. It'd be really interesting to see what happens a day in the life of Elton John, wouldn't it? I would love to actually be a fly on his shoulder and just go along and see what he does, who he meets, and that sort of thing. He's probably got 1,000 friends that he's got to fit into his life, you know, here and there and everywhere. So that would be a really, really cool thing to see. If you guys have any kind of a documentary like that, giving us a little bit more of a detailed look into the life of Elton John, send it my way. That'd be really interesting, man. All right, y'all. That is it for this excellent album. John, thanks very much, man. Great recommendation. Really loved all of the songs, man. Fantastic listen here. So, Sasha, Jeff, Randy, Cole, I've got reactions. I've got a hit up for you guys. Running a touch late here. I had a couple of back-to-back tribute reactions that I had to do, pushing things back a little bit. But hey, man, you know, when a great inspiration of the rock era, or, you know, from popular music passes, you got to stop and give them a moment, right? So I did that the other day. Check those out. Ian McDonald on the Classic platform and Betty Davis on the Beyond platform. They both passed on the 9th. All right, y'all. Have a good one. Take care. And the next time you see me will be tomorrow. And it'll be Sasha's reaction. I can't remember what he's got for us. Sasha is Amy Brooks's hubby, Sasha Ames. It's been a long time since I did anything with Sasha. I think the last time on this platform was, wasn't it a Jimi Hendrix album? Or was it a Beatles album? Damn, man. Yeah, it's been that long. So anyways, you'll see me do something in regards to Sasha's recommendations tomorrow. So until then, peace out.